Okay, I want to pick up on this idea of the U.S. having the lowest fatality rate when it comes to coronavirus. Donald Trump has been saying this a lot and said it to Chris Wallace during that completely gong show Fox News interview that we looked at earlier. And there are different metrics for different questions. And you are, I'm not saying you're being tricked, but there are attempts being made to trick you, which hopefully you aren't falling for. So let's start at the beginning. If we want to know where more people are dying, you look at the number of deaths, right? The problem is that number would not be adjusted for the population because different countries have different populations. So we want to look at per capita. If I say to you 1,000 people died of the virus in the US and 1,000 people died in Norway, it's 1,000 people in both cases, but Norway has a smaller population. So 1,000 people dying there is more per capita than in the United States. That's very simple. But I want to go in much more detail and look at three different metrics and tell you where they work and where they don't work. We have deaths per capita, we have the case fatality rate, and we have the infection fatality rate. Yesterday, Donald Trump, in his interview with Chris Wallace, said we have one of the lowest fatality rates in the world. And they put up a graph that the White House gave Fox News. And in this one, you have the UK at the top, you have the US in the middle, and you have Russia sort of closer to the bottom. But if you look at the top of this page, this is the case fatality rate. So the case fatality rate is simply deaths divided by confirmed cases. So as you can immediately notice, the case fatality rate depends on the number of tests that you do. If one person dies and 100 people tested positive, that is a case fatality rate of 1%, one out of 100. Notice that you can lower your case fatality rate by doing more tests. If one person dies, but I test 100 more people, meaning now I've done 200 positive tests, now your case fatality rate is only 0.5%. Nothing has changed about the portion of the population that has died. You've just tested more people and lowered your case fatality rate. So as you can see, you can lower CFR by testing more people. Interestingly, Trump's strategy has been to test fewer people, which hurts his own strategy of focusing on case fatality rate. So that gets us to infection fatality rate. So when you look at infection fatality, that's deaths divided by the total believed number of infections. So remember, we're not testing everybody. There are people who have had coronavirus who never got a test. So when we have 100 positive tests, we have to estimate, well, how many people were really infected? We might determine that there's a 2.5 times infection rate. So for every 100 tests that go positive, you estimate you really have 250 believed cases. So the infection fatality rate with one death over 250 believed cases is only 0.4%. Now, what's important is you can lower your infection fatality rate by arguing that there were way more asymptomatic people that had the virus and recovered and are fine. So if I argue, you know, for every positive test, there's probably 10 people who had it, I lower my infection fatality rate dramatically. That now gets us to deaths per capita. Deaths per capita are not tied to testing or any speculation about asymptomatic spread. You're simply dividing deaths by population. One death in a country of 100 people, that's 1% deaths per capita. Notice that deaths per capita only goes up over time, assuming that, you know, the population isn't growing explosively during a pandemic. So when a second person dies in a country of 100, your deaths per capita are now up to 2%. This is important because deaths per capita won't be impacted by the testing level. Deaths per capita won't be impacted by your estimate of how many asymptomatic cases they are. And when you look at that, the US is currently 10th highest in the world. Our deaths per million are 432. We're right behind Chile, which is at 442. So out of 200 plus countries and territories, we are 10th in the world. If you get rid of San Marino and Andorra, which are tiny, and when you include countries so small, it can sometimes be deceptive, we're really 8th in the world among reasonably sized countries. So the way that deaths per capita can be affected is that there could be coronavirus deaths that aren't being counted as coronavirus deaths. So you have to look at excess deaths compared to last year. If you do that, it seems as though we are probably undercounting the number of coronavirus deaths. So now you know, when Trump says we have the lowest death rate, he's probably referring to the case fatality rate, even though he's also wrong that ours is low. But really, we should focus on deaths per capita. Over time, if you want to compare how countries are doing, you want to look at deaths per capita. If you want to look at how deadly the disease is among people who get it, you would look at CFR and IFR. But for Trump's purpose, which is compare how we're doing to other countries, deaths per capita is the metric that we should be looking at. And of course, it's never the metric that Trump or Kayleigh McEnany or any of them are actually talking about. Hopefully this is useful, and we'll have some of the example data on the show's Instagram page. Follow us on Instagram at David Pakman Show. Let me tell you real quick about one of our sponsors, Cuts Clothing. They offer super quality men's t-shirts, and they're giving you 15% off when you go to davidpakman.com/cuts. That's C-U-T-S. Because solid color t-shirts are a really important staple in pretty much every guy's wardrobe, I think it's really important not to overlook the value of having t-shirts you love wearing. T-shirts from Cuts Clothing have been a game changer for me. And as a company, all they deal with are men's solid color t-shirts. So they actually put a ton of thought into the comfort, the style, the durability of the t-shirts they make. They fit perfectly. They're not scratchy. They don't shrink. They don't fade. They don't stretch out over time like so many other t-shirts. They're really the most comfortable t-shirts I've owned, and they look great. This right here that I'm wearing on YouTube is the split hem crew neck t-shirt. Very soft, fits me perfectly. It's the ideal length. Go take a look at what they offer. And once you have it, you are really going to see and feel the difference. Their slogan is, it's the only shirt worth wearing. You will see why. And you'll get 15% off when you do it by going to davidpakman.com/cuts. That's davidpakman.com/CUTS.